once again to Prime Time Wrestling. I'm Gorilla Monsoon, along with the Instigator.
I'm your host, Bobby the Brain Heenan. I haven't done anything wrong the last week. And
you started 1990. You started already by coming out here and lying to the people again.
How did I lie to the people?
Trying to get your men out of the Royal Rumble because you're scared to death.
We talked that over, and we've decided that Haku and Andre are staying in the Royal Rumble.
It's not a decision for you to make. The contracts were already signed.
You're locked in. But we're not going to try to get out of it. We have a plan.
Oh,
the family has
a plan,
including ravishing Rick Rude.
Why don't you tell the folks, if you know, in fact, what is the feature this week on Primetime?
Feature is the World's Strongest Man, Dino Bravo, against
self-proclaimed World's Strongest,
and against Super Sombrero, Tito Santana. They had a rough Christmas, the Santanas.
They did.
Oh,
how
yes.
How would you know about that?
Well, I understand they had a fire in their home. But they survived. They all moved into his aunt's Pontiac.
It's going to start again, folks. We just opened up.
Arriba.
He's going to start already. Also joining us here this week, Coco Beware, along with Bad News.
Have you ever seen Coco and Sapphire together?
Of course.
Oh, I thought maybe they were the same person.
No, they're not the same person. Don't be facetious.
Sometimes. No, I'm just enlightening the humanoid.
What did you do to your hair? You've done something to your hair. What little is left of it, well, I shouldn't talk because I don't have much left either. But
are you saying that Piper pulled some of my hair up?
Well, it's just...
This is the style of the 90s for me.
It is.
I change every
often. The fluff look, is that it?
Whatever you like to call it.
Is that the Royal Rumble look?
No, the Royal Rumble look is when you have Tums. That's the Royal Rumble look.
Tums, huh? I got news for you. We're going to start off here this week on Primetime Wrestling with someone who I know is very near and dear to the heart of the Brain. Hot Rod is with us, so let's go to ringside.
This contest is scheduled
for a tremendous crowd on hand here at the World Wrestling Federation at the Von Braun Civic Center in Huntsville, Alabama. Tony Schiavone,
Tony,
along with Lord Alfred Hayes. As we take a look at Tony Burton. Tony Burton has a real tough test. If you call it a test, because you hear the music and the fans begin to rise, because here he is, the one and only Rowdy Roddy Piper. Alfred, look at that crowd, much like the crowd I know is going to be on hand for the Royal Rumble on Sunday, January 21st.
Yes, and there's two great occasions. This, of course, today, but January the 21st, another great occasion. The Royal Rumble coming from Orlando, and it's on pay-per-view television.
It certainly is. Rowdy Roddy Piper will be one of the 30 men to participate in the Royal Rumble, and there's a fan standing cheer here, and Roddy looks around. As we know, it's not only how good you are, Alfred, it's what number you draw that has a lot to do with it.
There's a lot of the luck of the draw that goes along with that, because you're absolutely right, as you stated. And when you said in the beginning, this is a tough test for young Tony Burton.
It is indeed.
What a test.
And Tony Burton is doing some complaining already to Danny Davis, the referee, who in turn is complaining to Piper. What's going on here?
I'm not quite sure, but he's pointing out some rule there that Piper was questioning. I believe it was closed fists, and he's saying, open those hands.
A lot of talking, so evidently Piper agrees that he will leave the fist open. Once again, Tony Burton does some complaining. And finally, the two-man tie-up, Alfred.
Yes, he was a little reluctant there to come to grips with Piper. I don't blame him, because Piper showing a lot of intensity and a lot of fire in the ring here today.
A big push by Tony Burton. It appeared it was going to be a clean break from Rowdy Roddy Piper. However, Burton shoved off, and I think that may have started some fire in that tempo of Rowdy Roddy Piper.
He's smoldering. You're absolutely right. He's smoldering, and he said, well, the look said, if that's the way you want to play it, I'll do the same.
Great go behind from Piper on Burton. Burton tried the same thing, but Piper will not let go. Sends him into the ropes, and that will cause a break once again. We get a ring-level view of the action of the WWF, and you'll have the best view of all if you join us for the Royal Rumble on pay-per-view Sunday afternoon, January 21st. Like we said, 30 of the top stars. Roddy Piper, one of them, and a lot of issues, certainly. And implications in that, right hand, because Ravishing Rick Rude will be a part of the Royal Rumble also. Into the ropes now, clothesline, down goes Tony Burton.
Powerful, powerful clothesline there by Piper, and now a back suplex. He's doubled this out man up twice like a pair of scissors.
And there's a cover with a foot, one foot, and he gets it done. Wow, the talent of Roddy Piper. talented and capable Rowdy Roddy Piper is, he can pin the man basically, apparently, when he wants to.
He can indeed. Let us have another look and see what Piper did to his man here. He picked him up here, and here he takes him up for that back suplex, and watch the way he folds him up in this back suplex. Boom! Folded him. There wasn't much chance for Tony Burton to do anything at all there. A great victory for Piper.
Roddy Piper, your winner. Let's go back now to the Primetime Studios.
Rod showing everyone exactly what he's made of and what he's all about. And incidentally, Brian, he made a remark here about a week or so ago that he would like to be number one in the draw. He wants to be in there first and be there for the duration.
He wants to start.
He wants to get numbers one, two, or three at least.
What an idiot.
I think so.
The advantage of being the last number is everybody else is pretty well beat down and tired. You can go in and just heave him out.
Well, that tells me one thing. That shows me that this guy's just loaded with confidence and loaded with ability and loaded with endurance, as you well know.
Does the word stupid have any meaning to this?
No, it doesn't, because this is a Royal Rumble, and this is what it's all about. Suppose that it were the Hot Rod who drew number one, two, or three, and it was Hulk Hogan or the Warrior who drew one of those.
Or Ravishing Rick Rude.
Yeah, or you sticking your nose in.
Or Andre.
Let's take a look at where the WWF is headed. It's for me. That's correct.
They're programmed to do here.
They are. Yes, they are infringing on your rights. Your First Amendment rights. Absolutely.
Be talking to some Seamus with some gumshoe.
That's right. Apply some pressure. Get on the horn and start calling that particular system and tell them that you want them to carry the World Wrestling Federation pay-per-view events, Royal Rumble and everything else, WrestleMania 6 and everything else that goes on here in the WWF. That's what it's all about. That's what America is all about.
Call a massage parlor in Des Moines.
That's correct. Absolutely. The brain agrees with me on this.
Let me talk.
Hold on a second.
Who is she?
It's Harriet.
Harriet.
Same to you.
Right now, let's go to Mean Gene Okerlund.
From the pages of the World Wrestling Federation magazine, here's update.
All right, hi again, everybody. What about this blowout between the fashion model Rick Martel and Brutus the Barber Beefcake? As it turns out, Beefcake, quite a cut-up, no pun intended. But certainly, you have not heard the last of the feud between Rick the fashion model Martel and Brutus the Barber Beefcake. You've certainly not heard the last of the Royal Rumble. It's coming your way Sunday, January the 21st. Folks, you can see it on a pay-per-view basis, 4 p.m. Eastern Time from the Orlando Arena in Orlando, Florida. Now, let's go back, courtesy of the superstars of wrestling, to last week. Demolition Action Smash defending the World Wrestling Federation Tag Team Championship belts against the Colossal Connection, Andre the Giant and Haku. Action in progress. Ladies and gentlemen, you have witnessed World Wrestling Federation history made. New tag team champions. On the heels of that title bout last week, we got comments this week from all four men.
I told you. New World Wrestling Federation champions. The Colossal Connection.
One way to start the year.
What a way to start the year.
Happy New Year.
Happy New Year. Thank you. Let me take this one, too. Happy New Year.
Wait a minute.
Right here. We go here to the Colossal Connection. They're riding on cloud nine. The celebration, the limousine rides, the champagne. It doesn't last forever. We we know. Those belts belong to us, and we're coming back after them.
The bottom line is, we're standing up here without our belts. Bobby the Brain Heenan, we know what it's like to be to the top, and we're not going to cry, we're not going to bellyache, but we know how to get them back, and that's the fight.
New tag team champions here in the World Wrestling Federation, the Colossal Connection, Andre the Giant and Haku. Now, it's ironic that all four men, Demolition and the Colossal Connection, will be participants in the Royal Rumble on Sunday, January the 21st. Don't be denied the privilege of seeing this extravaganza on a pay-per-view basis. Call your cable system right now to see this and all other World Wrestling Federation pay-per-view spectaculars. With Update, I'm Gene Okerlund.
Our pal, Mean Gene, bringing us up to date on the Royal Rumble news that's happening. And it's all going to happen in Orlando, at the Orlando Arena in Florida, on January 21st.
Where you, did that's you where tell you... the people, well, I'll be in Orlando, but did you tell the people that I'm once again managing the World Wrestling Federation Tag Team Champions?
We told them that last week.
Well, just to refresh their mind, you know, these people, their retention span is about 11 seconds.
I didn't get a clear, concise answer last week to my question, Brain. Are you and the rest of the managers going to be allowed at ringside at the Royal Rumble?
Well, I don't concern myself with the other managers. I will be at ringside with my men. I don't know what they're going to do, and I could care less.
Well, that's not true, and you know it. I saw you over in the corner last week, surrounded by Mr. Fuji and the Colonel, and also the Slickster. Were you not?
Well, there was...
Yeah, what was that? It wasn't a card game, I guarantee you that.
No, I don't gamble.
No. Here's a guy that's not taking a gamble with 460 pounds, the Earthquake.
You bet.
The following contest is scheduled for
take
one
a look
ball.
At a crowd in Nashville, the auditorium, we're downtown. Tony Schiavone, Lord Albert Hayes, with the World Wrestling Federation. You notice how the excitement is building towards the Royal Rumble?
I do indeed. It's sort of electric, isn't it? You can feel it in the atmosphere, in the air, everywhere you go.
You know, Albert, it's every man for himself, and certainly it's the type of contest, the Royal Rumble, where they come in at 2-minute intervals, where possibly the biggest men could survive.
Well, I'll tell you something, I'd hate to have just entered the ring and 2 minutes later, here comes the Giant.
I would also.
I just hate that.
And I would hate to enter the ring and 2 minutes later would come the Canadian Earthquake. Wow. Over 400 pounds from Vancouver, the Canadian Earthquake going up against James Sexton, and he immediately goes to work. There's an intensity in this man, and certainly that has to be attributed to the Colonel Jimmy Hunt.
Yes, and he's flashing a notice, a warning to everybody who's watching him. What a very fast-moving Earthquake he is. A big 400-pounder who's extremely nimble on his feet.
Out goes Sexton, and he went headfirst at that.
Oh, he hit that canvas and went headfirst out of the ring to the concrete floor.
How do you prepare, Alfred, for a match against a guy the size of the Earthquake? What do you do?
Well, you've got to watch him very, very closely, obviously, and you've got to try and stay away from him and try and wear him down. And I'm afraid this youngster in with him, James Sexton, hasn't tried any of those maneuvers. Well, he got caught right in the very beginning. You've got to be alert.
And that has not been the case for Sexton, as all 420 goes down on Sexton, and he rolls right off of him when apparently he could have pinned him right there.
He could have easily done that. As I said at the outset of this match, he's flashing a warning to everybody. Watch me.
Hard not to.
You can't miss him.
You can't miss him at all, can you?
Sexton is a big kid, but he looks nothing the size of, with this man in the ring.
Right to the throat, sends him down, a warning from the referee. But the Canadian Earthquake, we've seen it before. He's a friend of Dino Bravo, so he's not going to pay much attention to the rules. Stomping around now through the Earthquake move, sending Sexton up and down the canvas, and here he goes. Watch out, all he goes down.
Watch this man, that is his prelude. You're absolutely right to the Earthquake, and he is going to do it again.
systems out here, but the Royal Rumble, certainly you got to figure the Canadian Earthquake, if he draws, let's say, a high number, like a number 29 or whatever. Well, now the men are checking, so the officials checking on Sexton. Obviously very hurt.
Tony, looking at the Earthquake there, I don't care whether he draws 29, 9, or 1. He's got to be a considerable force in that ring from the moment he enters it. And you know who, in his prelude to the Earthquake jump, when he stomps around that ring, he could be upsetting a lot of those people, in there, putting them off balance, and anything could happen. And here comes a stretcher. I thought this might be necessary.
Well, it's a shame to see this, because certainly James Sexton's career could come to an end. As you can see, clenching the chest, he could have...
He could have a sternum injury here.
Or a cracked rib or some internal injuries.
Well, I would say a little more than a cracked rib. He could have broken several of those ribs. And if he has broken those ribs, that is an injury that's going to put you out of wrestling for a couple of months.
The power and agility of the Canadian Earthquake, and the Royal Rumble is right around the corner, Sunday, January 21st. And as we said, as we see, unfortunately, James Sexton being carted off, the Earthquake certainly should be a factor in that all-important Royal Rumble coming up.
And look at the pain on his face there. My word. You know, I'd like to have a look again and see exactly the devastating move that the Earthquake placed upon James Sexton. See if we can see that. Well, here we are.
Now, this is the first time, right?
This is the very first one, yes. And here he comes, once from one rope, once from the other. And look at this, completely in the air, and crushes his chest.
And it was one of two of them to enter the Canadian Earthquake. Let's go back to the primetime studios.
I suppose you got knocked over by the Earthquake, right?
Everything just topsy-turvy.
That youngster might have just had his career terminated.
Tough,
huh?
Should have known better to get in the ring than the size of the Earthquake. That's going to be a force to be reckoned with in the World Wrestling Federation. I guarantee that.
I got the distinct feeling that the Canadian strongman Dino Bravo in the Royal Rumble will be hiding behind Earthquake.
Well, you know, if you just weigh the people...
Of course, the other 29 guys could almost hide behind him as well.
And they all could hide behind Andre. He's the odds-on favorite to win it.
He is.
You've got to admit that.
There are no odds-on favorites in the Royal Rumble. I got news for you. It's the luck of the draw, my friend, that's extremely important. That's why additional security has been added to the luck of the draw, the drawing that will take place in the locker room area prior to the Royal Rumble to make sure there's no... Thank you.
I hear head of security is going to be Captain Heenan from Beverly Hills. He's my uncle. He can be trusted.
We'll be right back after this.
Set on the take.
Hey, I've lost more hair than you've ever had on your head. Baby!
New 1990, the new decade calendar with all the photos of the superstars of the World Wrestling Federation. I know I gave away a whole bunch of them this year.
Probably lifted them off a truck when nobody was looking.
Oh, yeah, just...
You don't spend money on your friends, buy expensive gifts, like I do?
These are just casual acquaintances that I...
That's a 16-month edition. There's 16 months in
it. I understand that.
That's for all you guys that have been tanked for the last 3 months and forgot July, August, and September.
Let's take a look at Brutus.
Everybody beginning to stand to their feet.
Could very well have a different hairstyle after this matchup at the Royal Rumble. I would suspect that he's going to look a little different than he does right now.
I personally think he'll totally outsmart Beefcake. I mean, with his degree of knowledge against a guy who knows how to style hair, yeah. and does a bad job of that.
That's your opinion.
Hey, if anybody knows about hair, McMahon, it's me.
What do you know about it?
Hey, I've lost more hair than you've ever had on your head.
Maybe as Georgetown slams in a canvas with a party. Beefkin doing a little strutting. He may be cutting a little bit later on.
Beefkin.
Wait a minute. What's he doing here?
Those ridiculous clothes you have on. You think you look pretty good, huh? I think I'm going to go and take a closer look at you.
How about that?
Now there.
With George South. Off the rope, and oh! The same thing can happen to the genius!
I don't think so, McMahon. I think the genius is smart enough to figure out a way out of this hole. He's the one man with the brains I don't think that can be put to sleep.
Well, George South is going down! That's it! It's all over! Goodness.
you're down in the soup line with the homeless.
Oh, take a look at this.
There's Beefcake style of fashion, McMahon.
Brutus the Barber.
Oh, yeah. Stretch a stout. Look at Brutus go. Martel never looked this good.
Brutus the Barber, Beefcake, showing us he's not going to take any guff from the model.
That was a disgrace. Here, Rick Martel spends a fortune on his wardrobe, and Beefcake dresses like a bum. He's got rips and holes in his clothes. Can't take it. Every woman
They're
in the place has their eyes.
That way.
His their design. Clothes. He looks like a hand grenade salesman. He looks like Skolin. You ever see the
Arnold Skolin?
The Golden Boy. You ever see him towards the end of the week? When he's leaving one of those
will you stop?
Restaurants
will you
at 4 in the morning?
You don't you have enough enemies? You want to start with Arnold Skolin now, right?
No, you better never show his face on me. I'll drop him. And
I'll tell you what. Bruce the Barber Beefcake hasn't finished this confrontation with the model Rick Martel. But another big one that he's got coming up in the Royal Rumble that's going down on January 21st at the Orlando Arena in Orlando, Florida, is with an individual of completely different nature. Referring to the genius, here's a guy that never gets down on himself, and Brutus the Barber Beefcake will have to be on top of the situation at all times.
See, the genius is always prepared. He's mentally ready.
He's a great person.
He's a great physical athlete.
He's a sick person.
Well, you have to be a little sick to
the only attribute that he has, that he's a contortionist, Brain.
It's hard to keep him in a hold. He can get out. He has every escape for every hold you can put on.
He does, huh? He's right. Got a few holds that nobody else can do either.
January 21 at 4 p.m. Eastern. 30 World Wrestling Federation superstars are in one match. Where it's every man for himself. There are no allies, only enemies. This year, kick the new year off with a rumble, the Royal Rumble. Where it's friend versus friend, foe versus foe. Each wrestler will be thrown over the top rope, eliminated, until finally one man stands alone as a victor. Don't miss the Royal Rumble, January 21 at 4 p.m. Eastern.
Yeah, Arnie. Yeah, right here on Primetime Wrestling, he made some very derogatory statements about you.
Talking to Arnold Palmer, the great golfer.
No, I'm talking to Arnold Skolin, my friend for many, many years.
Master of the 19th hole.
Yeah, where are you now? Oh, you're here in town.
This? Conducting Primetime. Here we're talking about the Royal Rumble. We got a lot of things happening.
He's love
talking
to have
Arnold Skolin.
Come on down. Thank you. Bye-bye.
He's coming here?
I just said, love to have you. Hey, maybe we're going to have dinner or something. Who knows?
You better bring extra cash. He's never picked up a tab.
Well, that remains to be seen. Royal Rumble, indeed, hot on the minds of everyone here in the World Wrestling Federation. And this man, no exception, referring to the million-dollar man, Ted DiBiase. Let's take a look at him.
The following contest is scheduled for one fall. Entering the ring with his bodyguard, Virgil, making his winter residence in the Netherlands Antilles, weighing 260 pounds. Here is the self-proclaimed million-dollar champion, Ted DiBiase.
I wonder how long it took the Learjet to fly from the Netherlands Antilles to Nashville.
I don't know. I wonder who the pilot was.
I don't know. Certainly well paid, though. Well, now I shouldn't assume that.
No,
maybe
he's
not well paid.
You know, I've heard that millionaires are a little bit tight with their money anyway. That's how they become millionaires.
Oh, is that how that? Watch out from behind now. The million-dollar man going up against Dale Wolf. And he is going right after Dale Wolf. And he is working right away. As a matter of fact, standing by, looking onto this match with some comments, is Jake the Snake Roberts.
Just how many times can you spit in the wind without getting wet? How many times can you reach out and touch a flame without getting burnt? And how many times can you mess with a snake without getting bit? It's very simple, DiBiase. Royal Rumble, take the number that you get. Your luck has run out. Damien and I are watching you.
You know, Alfred, Jake the Snake has said it before. As you take a look at the million-dollar man going after Wolf, he has said it before. It doesn't matter to him what number he draws. He just wants to be in there when the million-dollar man is in there.
And one would hope that that does happen, and I'm sure it will. You know, if luck has its way of happening, you know, he has tried everything to get the million-dollar man into the ring, and this is one excellent chance for him to do just that. But don't forget, there's going to be a lot of other men in there, too.
That's right. It's going to be certainly every man for himself that is coming your way. The Royal Rumble, don't forget, Sunday, January 21st at 4 o'clock in the afternoon. And there's a side suplex from the million-dollar man. Down goes Dale Wolf.
Very nice move there by DiBiase. And obviously he wasn't able to pace Dale Wolf off at the beginning of this match because Dale's still in there with, let's say, a fighting chance.
And a butterfly suplex. We are seeing a lot of great moves from Ted DiBiase. Calling out to Jake the Snake Roberts. Claiming that that's going to Dale Wolf is what's going to happen to Jake the Snake Roberts. You made a good point about other men participating, 30 and all. Oh, great neck breaker. 30 of all in the Royal Rumble. So certainly if two men have an issue like Jake the Snake and the Million Dollar Man do, they're going to have to maybe weed through some guys to get to each other.
Oh, they will do, believe me. There's a lot of intensity on the part of both men, really, although DiBiase has been somewhat adverse to meeting Jake the Snake Roberts in the ring, but you can bet your life this is going to come, and it's going to happen.
And there was a great pile driver. The Million Dollar Man is in top form here. Here comes a power slam over the side ropes, and the Million Dollar Man certainly is well on his way to a victory here, and here comes a Million Dollar Dream.
Man, the main reason why there's going to be additional security at the drawing of the numbers for the Royal Rumble.
You know, you've made statements, and everybody has, as if Mr. DiBiase bribed somebody last time or used some of his money to influence his number last time.
Yeah.
Is there any proof of it? How you can make accusations like that about a man like Mr. DiBiase?
Some of the people said that they were offered a great deal of money to switch some numbers around.
Then why didn't they take it?
At the behest of the Million Dollar Man, Ted DiBiase.
And why didn't they take it?
They did take it.
And then they told on him? What a bunch of squealers. I wouldn't have said nothing.
You were on that list as well.
I never said how much. I never said he offered me anything.
Sure.
Were you trying to make it look like I...
Hey, a lot of things at stake here in the Royal Rumble, and a lot of money changed hands last time, folks.
20 grand's 20 grand. I mean, if that was the money he was going to offer somebody.
Here's a guy that never took a dime in his life, Sean Mooney.
Who?
Well, as you know, this is going to be one of the first events to take place in the 90s, and it's available exclusively on a pay-per-view basis. The Royal Rumble, happening Sunday afternoon, January 21st, at the Orlando Arena. Now, each superstar will draw a number. Last year, the Million Dollar Man, Ted DiBiase, implicated for buying the final number. That will not happen this year. Security has been stepped up. Also, four great matches will happen that afternoon, January 21st. And to tell you more about his match with the Barber, it's the Genius.
Hello, wrestling fans. It is the Genius once again. January 21st, I'm coming to Orlando, Florida. And I, full of glory and renown, I'm going to be wrestling Brutus the Barber Beefcake. Oh, he is so special. He is great. He is magnificent. He's so quick. However, his mind is somewhere out in Space Mountain, and all he can think about is cutting and a-strutting. The Genius, full of glory and renown, is thinking of victory.
It is going to take every ounce of intelligence the Genius possesses if he plans to walk away the victor in this match against Brutus the Barber Beefcake. 30 superstars, the World Wrestling Federation involved in the Royal Rumble. Topping the list, the World Wrestling Federation champion, Hulk Hogan.
You know something, Hulkamaniacs? January 21st, Orlando, Florida, the Royal Rumble has to be the hardest day in the year for all the WWF contenders, brother. I'm not going to come out here and tell you that it's a cakewalk, that I'm going to choose sides with friends, that I'm going to hope and pray for a high number so that I don't have to be in the ring very long. Everybody gets a number at random. 2 minutes apart, another man comes to the ring. It could be Andre the Giant. It could be Akeem. It could be the Macho Man. It could be Mr. Perfect. It could be the Warrior Beefcake. You never know who's sneaking up behind you. But all I got to say is Hulkamania is going to run wild in Orlando. And I hope I get number one just to prove that Hulkamania is the strongest force in the universe.
Be a part of the Royal Rumble. See it Sunday, January 21st. Available on a pay-per-view basis. Call your local cable company for availability.
Bring the royal affair right into your own home. The Royal Rumble, available on a pay-per-view basis Sunday afternoon, January 21st. Don't miss it.
Have a clue what I'm talking about, do you?
Of course I don't.
You don't think it's legal?
Sure.
You do?
Of course. Whatever you want.
Idiot, you. You fence rider. You actually approve of the big boss man walking in there with that 35-pound ball and chain.
I like it.
And annihilating someone with it.
I like it.
Do you think that Hacksaw Jim Duggan is going to let that happen to him in the
world? I hear rumors through the grapevine that he's going to put that chain around his neck. Think how that's going to
Without Hacksaw just going to lay there and let him do that, right?
If he's smart. If he makes a move, he's going to get his tail kicked real bad. See, you can hit the Hacksaw all day long with a nightstick. He can only see on one side. See, one side it looks like maybe 10 cops are coming at you. This side, nothing. So if you get on his left side, you can pretty well waffle him pretty good. That's the rumor I
hear. What a fountain of misinformation. Let's go to ringside, take a look at Hacksaw.
Hey.
Well, a 2x4 high in the air of Hacksaw Jim Duggan. As you take a look at the capacity crowd on hand for the WWF, thumbs up for the one and only man of a Glen Falls, New York.
Here is Craig Green.
He doesn't seem impressed, does he?
No, he soon will be, though, don't you?
You're exactly right, Lord Alfred Hayes.
When the Hacksaw gets his hands on you, boy, you remain impressed, too. A little boom, boom there.
And he is ready to fire. Ready to go. Hacksaw Jim Duggan has a very, very special match coming up during the Royal Rumble. He will go up in the ring against the Big Boss Man.
Yes, and he's been waiting for this opportunity to get the Big Boss Man in the ring by himself.
Big Boss Man, I sure feels the same way. As a matter of fact, what is the Big Boss Man thinking at this time?
Duggan, we're going to meet in the Royal Rumble, and you're going to find out why all of America looks up to me, because the Big Boss Man's style of justice is the American way. So, boy, when you step in the ring with me, you better suck that last breath in deep, because it's going to be the last free breath you take for a long, long time.
You think his brand of justice is the American way, Lord Alfred?
Wow, I really can't comment on that. All I can comment is that is one huge, violent, brutal man.
And it's going to take a huge man to knock him down, maybe out of a three-point stance. Watch here. Hacksaw Jim Duggan out of Hut 1. And Craig Green wanted no part of it.
Well, I'm not going to say he's a coward, but he certainly showed a lot of judgment there. Good judgment.
Right.
Right hand to the side. Oh, it really decked him. Right hand to the side of the face. And Craig Green goes down hard. And that wasn't on the mat. That was right on the concrete floor. Up the chute towards the dressing room there. And watch out now. Right into the post goes Craig Green.
And look at that man there. He is so charismatic. Our camera took us almost into his mouth there. What a fantastic shot that was. He will not be denied.
Hacksaw right after him. It's been all offense from Hacksaw Jim Duggan. The Royal Rumble and his big match against the Big Boss Man. What a great matchup that'll be. Scoops him up and slams him down. A determined face, and now out of the three-point stance. Here he comes. Hacksaw ready to go again. Green is up, and watch out! Oh, he decapitated him that time.
Oh, I love his tenacity. He stayed with that. He was determined to get that three-pointer in, and it brings him a victory. What a wonderful victory. Let's have a look and see that three-pointer. Here he comes, running across a tremendous clothesline. Jim Duggan.
Macho King, Randy Savage, what better person could you have in the Royal Rumble than the King?
So Sherry says, it all seems to fall in place. But, you gotta understand, there's thousands and thousands of pounds of humanity in there.
Absolutely.
It's gonna be very hard to win that. The secret to it is to be the last two in there. That's my thinking. That's where Andre and Haku.
Well, it's very possible that if you naturally, the higher number that you draw, the more it is to your advantage. However, you could draw number 27, 28, 29, or even 30, and go down to the ring and still find 15 guys in there, Brain.
That's right. And after every 2 minutes, you never know who's coming. You never, it might be somebody to help you.
Well, if you got think, number 30, you can bet there's nobody else coming.
Well, you never know.
Unless it's you and...
But you see, nobody has a friend out there. It's every man for themselves.
That's correct.
So when some guy hits the ring, you might, Jake the Snake might think it's Duggan, his buddy, but Duggan might just waffle him.
Maybe we'll get some words of wisdom from the Macho King right now. He's with Mean Gene.
My first guest of the new year, along with sensational Queen Sherry, is the Macho King, Randy Savage.
Another guy you're going to have to keep your eye on, January 21st, at the Royal Rumble. And royalty in the Royal Rumble, you better keep your eye on him.
Well, Gorilla, could 1990 be the year of the king?
What?
Macho King.
Would surprise me.
All right, and a forthcoming issue of the World Wrestling Federation magazine on sale on newsstands this coming Tuesday. Very interesting reading in an article entitled Throne of Power. Is sensational Queen Sherry the Macho King's weapon? What about it?
It's just jealousy. Jealousy from everyone in the World Wrestling Federation because nobody can beat the Macho King. Oh, yeah.
You know, speaking of royalty, and I'll give you that, you are royalty. There's going to be an event this coming January 21st, Sunday night in Orlando, called the Royal Rumble. Very appropriate for you, Macho King.
Who's more suited for the Royal Rumble than the Macho King? Royalty! Everyone in the Royal Rumble, all those arms and legs that belong to people like the Ultimate Warrior, Hulk Hogan, Roddy Piper, even Andre the Giant, they will all fall in Orlando, Florida to the Macho King. Ooh, yeah.
Queen Sherry, the other guest of Brother Love of the Royal Rumble, will be none other than the manager for the American Dream, Dusty Rhodes, Sapphire.
Let me tell you something, Mean Gene.
Yeah, I want to hear this.
If Sapphire sticks her nose in my business, I'm going to send her way back to Mom's Maidly Land, where she came from to begin with.
Please, give me a break, Macho King.
The Royal
and all you folks out there should be ready as well. Don't forget, this is the big pay-per-view event of the World Wrestling Federation, first one of 1990. And all you Dish and Descrambler owners out there, don't think I've forgotten about you, because I haven't. Just pick up that warm telephone and call Primetime 24 at 1-212-599-4445 and partake of the World Wrestling Federation Royal Rumble. You will not be left out.
What's a warm phone?
That's opposed to a hot phone.
You mean someone lifted it from someplace?
No. It's just a figure of speech, dummy.
Not a dummy.
You're not, huh?
No.
Roll it. You keep your mouth shut and your legs crossed, you'll never be in trouble in your entire life. Believe me. Take my word for it. Plenty more action still to come here on this edition of Prime Time.
What does that mean?
What does that mean?
Phone's cold.
Phone's cold. Coming up right now... Who we got coming? Bad news?
Bad news.
Or good news?
Bad news and Paul Roma.
Bad news, Brown. Take it away.
Way towards the ring area from Harlem, New York. Weighing 271.
Harlem, New York, the home of bad news. Brown, Lord Alfred Hayes. We are in the Caps Coliseum in Hamilton, Ontario for this big event. Bad news, Brown, and I think if you look at all the participants in the Royal Rumble, the man best suited for the Royal Rumble would be a man on his own.
this man. I was recently in Europe, the same as you were. We were in France, if you remember, in Paris, and we saw his match, and they just detested him there.
Wow, you're right.
But there's no denying this man has tremendous ability.
But if I can deviate from my thought right here, they may have detested Bad News Brown, but they love Lord Alfred Hayes.
They did?
In Europe. They certainly did.
Well, I didn't notice that with the young maidenry of Paris.
All right, a very stern look on the face of Paul Roma. He grabs Bad News. He goes right to work quickly. Roma over the top. Sunset Flip is going to try to end it quickly here. Now he got a two count, but he's back to it once again. This is the right thing to do, Lord Albert Hayes.
It is indeed. And if Roma had been able to hook those 2 feet over the shoulders of Brown then when he came in with a beautiful move, we may have had a very, very quick finish to this particular match. Roma looking sharp indeed.
Bad News Brown. Room area, but now as the referee jumps on Paul Roma, I guess a little bit, Bad News Brown still remains on the floor.
Well, I don't know why he should verbally assault Roma, because Roma did exactly what was expected of him, and he did the right thing.
Again, flips him in from the outside here and using the top rope. Roma waiting on Bad News. Bad News swinging wildly and missing. And Roma picks him up.
To allow Brown to get back into the ring without counting him out. Roma obviously wants to finish this man right in the middle. Very commendable.
Let's see if that happens. Bad News Brown, certainly Bad News Brown has a little bit of strategy here. Oh, now wait a second.
Now I hope Roma doesn't fall for this.
Look at that smile. Showing the pearly whites, and Paul Roma shouldn't buy this at all.
That must have been a first for us, Tony. I've never seen him smile before.
Don't think I have either.
That must hurt his face, huh?
Yeah, it must. Alfred, certainly these tactics of walking back to the dressing room, wanting the handshake, has really slowed down the tempo of this match. And certainly, I guess would put it maybe back towards his favor a little bit more.
Oh, definitely. There's no doubt about that whatsoever. And do you think that this is some sort of ploy he's using against Roma to show that he can do anything he wants to and laugh in his face?
I don't know.
Get away with everything?
Well, Paul Robeson just maybe gave him a swift kick right to the head or something. Let's see what happens. Paul Roma certainly has let Bad News Brown slow down the pace of this match. And right now, Roma's paying more attention across his fingers. You saw the hand behind Bad News Brown.
Well, the referee, strangely enough, has told Roma that he doesn't have to comply. I would have thought that that was superfluous. Roma can surely make up his own mind. He's big enough, strong enough, and old enough.
Paul Roma, is he going to shake this hand or not?
Magnificent wrestler, this man. He is so durable. He absorbed all that punishment from Roma, played for a little time, came back into the ring, and he is right on top of his man.
A headbutt to Roba. Roba still will not go down. There he goes. After the third headbutt, Paul Roba dips. Not by bad news, Brad. A lot of our fans out there decked by the fact that many cable systems will not be carrying the Royal Rumble. We suggest you give yourself the cable systems a call and inquire about that.
This is the most important date in the World Wrestling Federation calendar for January the 21st, so I would suggest that everybody calls their station, quite honestly.
All those systems and inquire about the Royal Rumble, and now Paul Roma being choked by bad news, swinging him back with the top rope.
Roma paying for that one tiny error he made. But Roma also is a very durable wrestler. He is in fantastic condition, and conditioning is 90% of your war inside the ring.
Into a corner, the referee trying to get bad news to back away, but the chokehold is applied to Roma, who's in a lot of trouble here with using the attack. What's a tag rope doing here in a singles match, for goodness sake? It just gives him another weapon.
It really does. It shows that somebody is a little bit amiss there, because that should have been removed. The referee should have looked at that ages ago. I don't blame the referee, but somebody should.
Is that a tag rope, or is that one of the ropes that ties the turnbuckle together?
I believe that's what it is. I believe that really is a turnbuckle tie rope. Yeah.
Whatever it is, it's being used to choke Paul Roma and give Bad News Brown a definite advantage here.
Yes, and he's going for the other one.
Yeah, he sure is. So that's exactly what's happening. He has taken off the turnbuckle to expose the steel cutter. We have two steel hooks that come together right there, Alfred, as you know.
And Roma in a lot of trouble now, and it's obvious what Bad News Brown is trying to do. He's trying to get this man and run his head into that steel turnbuckle.
Roma blocks it. Oh, there goes Bad News. The head right to the turnbuckle, so it backfired on Bad News Brown.
It did indeed. And Bad News Brown now rolling about, holding that very, very hard head of his. And this has given a lot of advantage, a lot of to young Paul Roma.
Right hand, sure, the right hand to Bad News. And again, Bad News finally goes down. Roma, seeing the opportunity, goes up top with a high risk maneuver here. Could it be a mistake? We'll find out. No, sir. Right on target. Roma, head of cover. He's got the leg. He could have the win. No, sir. He just missed.
Very, very close there by Roma. And that is his domain on top of the top rope there. And he came down with great accuracy and really belabored Bad News Brown.
Elbow out of the ropes. Roma again hooking the leg. And for the second time, Bad News Brown just escapes. And Roma thought that would have been a three count.
Well, that was a picture-perfect pin that he had there on Bad News Brown. Yet Bad News, with all that raw power in that body, those tree trunk legs, managed to get away from him.
And now to the other side. Watch out, sending Roma in. To a turnbuckle. The only thing Bad News did was just step out of the way. Certainly behind the ghetto blaster. He nailed him with that elbow.
Oh, what a devastating move! And that looks... Yes, it is!
A three count. Let's get the official word.
Here is your winner, Bad News Brown.
Just a most impressive victory. He is so accurate with his ghetto blaster. Let's have a look at that ghetto blaster and see how he delivers it again. First we see where he's got this pin on Roma, got him down, and now we see it. Boom! Look at that. Oh, so precise with that move. Nobody gets up from that.
And he is ready for the Royal Rumble. This Bad News Brown, and he better be. Let's go back to the primetime studio.
Earlier on, Brain, you mentioned about odds-on favorites in the Royal Rumble. If there's a guy that's strictly a loner, and a guy that's dangerous, and a guy that doesn't have any friends, talking about Bad News, for your information.
No, he's used to being a loner. He doesn't trust anybody. He could pull this one out.
Well, we're going to go from a guy that's a loner and doesn't have any friends to one of the most well-loved and respected men here in the World Wrestling Federation, a guy that's been around here for a long time, referring to my longtime personal friend, Arnold Skolin. Arnold, please come up. Arnold Skolin.
You know, it's always a pleasure to see you.
Welcome to Primetime Wrestling. You're the first guest of 1990, the new decade.
It's a pleasure.
Here on Primetime Wrestling. Arnie, everybody's buzzing around the nation about the cable companies around that are not carrying the Royal Rumble. In fact, some of them are saying that they're not going to carry WrestleMania 6 and are not going to carry any of the pay-per-view events of the World Wrestling Federation anymore.
I think that's unfair to the customers because I think everybody wants to see this, and they should write in and demand that they want to see
it. Pick up the phone, call your congressman,
everything.
Call your senator. You know that this guy's been making some derogatory remarks about you.
Well, they consider the source.
Oh.
I've always said you were a great competitor and one of the greatest athletes the World Wrestling Federation
ever
had.
But you always say that to my face. You never say it behind my
face. Turn around, say it to you.
There's a lot of things he says behind your back.
No.
But he's in enough trouble now. He's got the hot rod on his case. And you're in deep trouble. Arnie, I want to thank you for dropping by.
It's always
anytime,
a pleasure.
Anytime, come by and say hello. You're always welcome here on Primetime Wrestling. What? Yeah. No, he doesn't want to shake hands with you. He doesn't want to shake hands with a hypocrite like you. Coming up in mere moments here,
He's mad because he can't get it?
Yes, of
course. He don't even have a TV. They don't have any TVs at a mission. He has to stand in line with guys all day to get the soup and one cigarette butt.
Serious. Stay with us, because coming up very shortly, believe it or not, Rhythm and Blues. Actively involved in the Royal Rumble, along with his partner, the Anvil, although...
Partners don't mean anything.
Remember that when we talk about Andre the Giant and Haku.
They're well aware of it.
They are.
They're competitors.
Yeah. Don't forget, there'll be no tagging involved in this whatsoever.
You've got to be in that room.
You're in there, you're in there.
That's right.
So Andre can't be wandering around on the apron doing his thing out there. Just keep that in mind. Interesting tag team match coming up right now. The Honky Tonk Man and the Hammer.
That if he's going to get support anywhere in the world, it would be here in Nashville. He has performed a few concerts here, and he hasn't stopped the town out.
The Honky Tonk Man, certainly part of the Royal Rumble, as well as the Earthquake and Dino Bravo, all men of the Mouth of the South, Jimmy Hart. I wonder how he feels about the Royal Rumble and his chances.
You know, sometimes I amaze myself, baby. What a combination I put together. Greg the Hammer Valentine, the Honky Tonk Man. It's like putting together a little bit of rock and a little bit of soul. And in the Royal Rumble, one of these men will win it.
Well, Greg the Hammer Valentine, the man starting up against very limber Mark Young.
What was all that? That was pretty neat, Alfred.
It really was. I really like that. It certainly bamboozled Greg the Hammer. He just looked at him absolutely astounded. And you don't often see that from Valentine.
Took my concentration for a second, I can tell you that. But what I was talking about, the special submission match, Rugged Roddy Garvin against Greg the Hammer Valentine.
Oh, what a brutal form of match this is. Because you just don't win this with pinfalls or knockouts. You have got to get a submission on your opponent. And that is a difficult thing to do.
Great move by Mark Young of a great drop kick. And now up top, Reno Riggins. Reno Riggins with a double axe handle blow over the top. Right down to the Hammer, Greg Valentine. Valentine holding his ground, though. He's absorbed some punishment, but it's apparent that he's in control here. Sending Reno Riggins back, and now Rhythm and Blues at their best, double-teaming the corner.
And these are two veteran wrestlers, Valentine and the Honky Tonk Man, and they're going to give these youngsters a lesson in wrestling. And one does feel a little sympathy for them having to enter the ring against these two, especially when they're turning up for the Royal Rumble.
Foot first, or head first to the foot, and the Hammer gets the tag in. Great teamwork here from Rhythm and Blues. It's the Hammer. I can only assume that he is the blues part of the...
Well, he'll bruise you, Blues, that's for sure.
That's right. That's exactly right, Alfred. Great butterfly suplex. Another great tag. Valentine, nicely done. Valentine knows a lot about tag team wars.
He certainly did. That was a good block to keep Reno Riggins in the ring and allow Honky Tonk to do some damage, or more damage, should I say, to that man.
Well, you heard it earlier from Colonel Jimmy I. One of his men will be the winner of the Royal Rumble. Will it be Dino? Will it be the Earthquake? Will it be the Honky Tonk Man? He'll be talking all the way to the bank if he gets a win, I'm sure. However, there are more than just three in the Royal Rumble, Albert. There are 27 more.
There are, and there's one man in particular I really like, and of course that is the World Wrestling Federation champion himself, Hulk Hogan. What a force this man is.
And what about the Ultimate Warrior? He's right in there also as part of the Royal Rumble. One of the 30. It's going to be great. It's going to be Sunday, January 21st on pay-per-view. The Hammer knocking down Reno Riggins. Reno laying in a good blow there. Side headlock. Could not follow up, though, Alfred, that time. He gets dropped right on the knee.
That was a good move by Valentine. He took his man up once and then took him up again to get extra height. This comes crashing down with a midsection head blow.
The midsection head blow was right on target. The height breaker adjusted. Valentine, don't forget the special submission match. It's going to be the height breaker against the Hammer Jammer. Valentine against Garvin. He's got it on, and there it is, a figure four. It's not going to take Reno Riggins long to give up, and that's about all. A big win for Rumble and Blues. Let's get the official word.
Here are your winners, Red the Hammer Valentine and the Honky Tonk Man.
A most impressive victory there by Rhythm and Blues, the Honky Tonk Man and Valentine. And here's that move I spoke of earlier. Valentine takes him up twice, two left for Reno Riggins, and he clamps on a vicious figure four leg lock.
This went for Rhythm and Blues. Right now, let's take you to Gorilla and Bobby the Brain Heenan at the Primetime Studios.
Both of these superstars of the World Wrestling Federation, referring to the Honky Tonk Man and the Hammer, involved in the Royal Rumble. Of course, Honky in the 30-man over-the-top Royal Rumble, and of course, the Hammer in a submission match.
Let me ask you a question. After the Hammer makes Ronnie Garvin give up, can he enter the Royal Rumble?
No. None of the people involved in single or tag team matches that are already signed for this event can get involved.
So there's a lot of extra things happening. It's just...
Oh, absolutely. Absolutely. Are you kidding?
Brother Love's
what makes you think that Rugged Ronnie's going to quit? Give me. He's not a quitter.
Makes you think he isn't.
Because he's got the Hammer Jammer.
That's why. Brother Love is going to be there. He's going to be interviewing Queen Sherry and Sapphire.
I can't wait for that. I can't wait for that. Please.
Sapphire.
You know the ramifications involved in that? We could see Brother Love get his clock cleaned.
And you could also see the... I won't say it.
Oh, forget about it. Let's go to Mean Gene Okerlund.
All right, hi again, everybody. Here we go. Orlando, Florida, Sunday, January the 21st, 4 p.m. Eastern start. It's going to be the Royal Rumble. 30 of the greatest superstars in the World Wrestling Federation all in one match. Heaven forbid that a couple of men we saw last week, Dino Bravo, Canadian strongman, and the current reigning Intercontinental Champion, the Ultimate Warrior, don't happen to cross paths in the Royal Rumble. Let's go back to the superstars of wrestling right here last week when these two men had a very unlikely meeting.
The Warrior is looking on. Hey, what? How come you don't complain when you see the Warrior pick somebody up when the match is over and dump them back by the dressing room?
Wait a minute, the Warrior!
Time, yeah! Bravo coming outside!
action from last week right here on the Superstars of Wrestling. This week, we got comments from both men, the Ultimate Warrior, and this man, Canadian strongman Dino Bravo.
Ultimate Warrior, you don't ever, ever stick your nose in my business. You already know I'm the most powerful man in Royal Rumble Night. We may leave you there forever, Warrior. 28 other weak human mortal beings that you have to run and hide behind, Dino Bravo. You should be glad I only stuck one small facial feature in your business, for you will fall and realize how weak you are when I bring the entire structure to Royal Rumble.
In the course of a Royal Rumble, it could be possible for these two men to meet. It also could be possible for the Rockers, Shawn Michaels and Marty Jannetty, to have to face each other. What about the Demolition, Axe and Smash? Some very tough decisions have to be made in this type of competition. 30 of the greatest in the Royal Rumble. But hold on. Is there more? You had better believe it. In tag team action, the Fabulous Rougeaus square off against the Bushwhackers. A submission match where the only way you can win is to get your opponent to submit to your leg lock. Greg the Hammer Valentine with a figure four. His opponent, Rugged Ronnie Garvin, with the Hammer Jammer. Plus one-on-one, Brutus the Barber Beefcake and this man, the Genius.
If I were not the genius and the world's smartest man, Royal Rumble would have somehow lost its glory. While the secrets of my flaming soul surpass the ebbless tide, Brutus Beefcake shall emit another story.
A special edition of the Brother Love Show during the Royal Rumble. Brother Love's dual guest will be Sapphire, the manager for the American Dream, Dusty Rhodes, and sensational Queen Sherry, manager for the Macho King, Randy Savage. You talk about bad blood one-on-one, a big singles match. The Big Boss Man will be meeting this gentleman. He is Hacksaw Jim Duggan.
Hey, folks, the 1990 Royal Rumble. I'm not in the Rumble, but I'm in a fight. A fight with a big boss man. And boss man, you bring that ball and chain, that club, and slick, because Hacksaw has a 2x4.
What an outstanding lineup, the Royal Rumble from the Orlando Arena in Orlando, Florida, on Sunday, January the 21st. And, folks, you can be part of it, yes. Don't be denied the privilege of seeing the Royal Rumble to the comfort of your home. Don't be shut out. Contact your local cable system right now and let them know you want to see the Royal Rumble and all other World Wrestling Federation pay-per-view events. The Royal Rumble from Orlando, Sunday, January the 21st, 4 p.m. Eastern start. With your Royal Rumble report.
A new song of his, Bird, Bird, Bird. It's kind of nice.
What is it?
Bird, Bird, Bird. Not Larry either.
Catchy tune.
It is.
I took a lot of mentality to write that one. Bird, Bird, Bird.
That's just the name of it. You obviously
I don't like
haven't
birds.
Heard it, right?
Obviously, I don't want to hear it.
You don't want to hear it?
No.
Well, you wouldn't want
to
be
Sapphire
on the receiving
should sing it together.
End of anything else that Coco can do as well. Let's go to ringside. Bird.
The following contest is scheduled for one fall. Currently in the ring, weighing in at 282 pounds and hailing from Hamilton, Ontario, Canada.
In front of him, because the man he's facing, Iron Mike Sharp, is dedicated to physical perfection. He's a man who will not step into the ring unless he's 100% in shape, and believe me, he goes all the way. Coco has a big task in front of him here, and as you say, in front of his home crowd.
The very colorful, and that's to say the least, Coco Beware. Look here, the fans in Nashville.
They love him.
Doing the bird.
And so they should. He's proved to be a very, very successful wrestler. A great representative for Nashville. Well, Tennessee more than that. And there is, of course, Frankie.
And he's going to get a ringside seat since it goes Coco Beware squares off against
think he seems to be very interested in you, Tony.
Look this way, didn't he?
Maybe he's got an egg for you.
Watch out, Coco Beware leveled by Mike Sharp, right hand against the side of the back. Again, slapped him right down.
At the moment, Coco not faring too well against the big Canadian. And we get a little bird's-eye view of what's going on in the ring there.
I knew you were going to say that. Right up against the ropes now. Iron Mike Sharp with the leg across Coco Beware, the back of the head. And slings him back. Sharp doing some early celebration here.
Well, he certainly is, but he's doing very, very well indeed. Against Coco, he's really mustering a very good offensive attack against him.
But he's head down, though, and that was a mistake. Alvarez gave Coco the chance to slip the elbow.
Yes, you can't be a little slow in thinking against Coco. Although Coco was practically out on his feet, he was able to hit him very, very hard behind the back of the neck.
Speaking of getting hit very, very hard, what about that one? It took him right off his feet.
Yes. Iron Mike back to 100% ability. Oh, nice trap!
Back slide! May have him, knowing he had a two count. Iron Mike escaped from that. And he's the first one to his feet. Back to Coco again. So just a slight interruption for the offensive Iron Mike Sharp. He's back to the attack once again. Going in after Coco Beware. Deep into the corner. Once again, right hand. Hard right hand from Iron Mike. That was a big one. Roundhouse that time.
It was indeed. And you would have thought that that really slick move there by Coco would have shaken the confidence of Mike Sharp. But no, not him. He just carries on just the same way. If it moves, hit it. If it doesn't move, drop kick it.
Into the ropes again. Down goes Coco. Nicely done. He comes up behind body press and gets a two count. Didn't really have a good cover that time, but it was a good move to get him down.
I really think that Coco's getting his second win in this match.
Watch out. Here he goes. Picks up a big man in the Ghostbuster. Oh, he put him out with that. Quickly. Coco Beware out of nowhere picks up the win. Let's get the official word. And if I could paraphrase you, Lord Alfred Hayes, he picked up a win from the jaws of defeat. Wouldn't you say something like that?
Absolutely, a first impressive victory by Coco Beware.
Coco Beware doing this thing. Of course, Coco also one of the 30 men involved in the Royal Rumble. You know, I kind of like, Brain, the guys that are quick and sort of on the light heavyweight side, like the Rockers and Coco Beware and Ravishing Rick falls into that category, and the Macho King, guys who can move around quickly and be evasive, because that's what it's all about in the Royal Rumble.
But there's not much room to move when there's 30 guys in there.
Well, that's why it's so important to be able to move, not like that big, cumbrous Andre the Giant who can't even get out of his own way. He'll probably be one of the first guys eliminated.
You want to bet? I'll bet you anything. I'll bet you a date with Sapphire.
Yeah?
Yeah.
You'd like to
see how bad
day.
You want to win.
You'd like to have a day with Sapphire,
you
wouldn't you?
Are kidding me?
Huh?
Hey, I met Mom's
Queen
Mabley
Sherry
20 years ago.
Is more your type, believe
she
me.
She is beautiful.
Yeah, she is. She ought to spend a little less time on her makeup and a little more time shaving underneath her armpits.
The afternoon, January 21 at 4 p.m. Eastern. World Wrestling Federation superstars are in one match, where it's every man for himself. There are no allies, only enemies. This year, kick the new year off with a rumble, the Royal Rumble, where it's friend versus friend, foe versus foe. Each thrust will be thrown over the top rope, eliminated, until finally one man stands alone as a victor. Don't miss the Royal Rumble, January 21 at 4 p.m. Eastern.
Feature time this week on Primetime Wrestling, 1990 style. Tito Santana taking on Canadian strongman Dino Bravo.
Tito's quick, he's fast, he has ring knowledge, but Bravo's just too strong. And Bravo has Jimmy Hart, and you never know, the earthquake might be there.
Has Dino Bravo ever held any of the titles here in the World Wrestling Federation?
No.
No. Tito Santana has a number of them on a number of occasions. True or false?
Well, I mean, he was World Wrestling Federation Tag Champion, Intercontinental Champion, and Rio Grande Surfer.
Enough said from you, Brain.
Amigo.
Prime time right here. Let's go to it. Let's go to ringside.
See, this contest is scheduled.
We are set to go with our feature matchup here at primetime from the Cubs Coliseum in Hamilton, Ontario. And Lord Alfred Hayes, really excited about this matchup because Dino Bravo, Tito Santana, it's going to be a great one.
It certainly will. The extremes are here for us to witness. Raw power and strength from that man, and a lot of finesse and speed from Tito Santana.
What will win out? Will it be the brute raw strength or the speed and finesse? Both men are veterans of the ring. They know all about it, all the tactics, and we'll just see who prevails. Notice, though, the Canadian earthquake, not with Dino Bravo. I wonder if that's going to maybe alter his game plan.
I'm not quite sure, but of course, Dino Bravo is a very dangerous man, with or without the mouth of the South with him, with or without the earthquake. He could certainly control his own matches, but here against Santana, it is an enormous task.
It is an enormous task as the fans start standing ready to cheer as we are set to go for Tito Santana's entrance here at the Cubs Coliseum. Now, don't forget that not only Dino Bravo is a very confident Tito Santana, but also Tito Santana, both will be part of the Royal Rumble on Sunday, January 21st.
They certainly will be. What a dynamic battle that is going to be. I have never seen such a list of 13 wrestlers ever in my life who have entered for this tremendous event, the Royal Rumble.
I'm going to ask you, Alfred, I want our fans watching on primetime to get ready for Lord Alfred Hayes and your prediction of who you think will win the Royal Rumble.
I just knew you would do that to me.
I'll give you another week. How does that sound?
Yes, give me another week.
I'll give you another week to let you think about it.
Well, I tell you what, I'm looking, in fact, to somebody like, well, I've got to say it from Bobby Heenan's stable there. You know, Haku has a lot of strength, a lot of ability. It could be him, or it could be the giant himself.
It could be Tito Santana. Tito is such a veteran. And if he gets the right number, it's a lot of breaks. Watch out, a little shoving match going on here. Bravo wanted to do some intimidating to Tito Santana. That's not going to do that.
No, definitely not. Tito Santana is onto every move of Bravo. He's done all his homework. He knows exactly what not to do, and definitely what to do against this man.
Santana gets the roar of the crowd. And I would think this is basically Dino Bravo's backyard.
Well, one would like to think that, but I don't think so. The people are not giving him too much encouragement, are they? Much to his disgust.
We're in Canada, but they don't like the Canadian strongman. They like Tito Santana from Tacoma, Mexico. And Bravo doesn't like this at all.
No, before the match even gets started, Bravo wants another shot at coming back into the ring, I would imagine. He was definitely showing a lot of disapproval there by this crowd packed in here at the Cup Stadium in Hamilton, Ontario, Canada.
Bravo on his way back in. Who's he talking to now?
I think this is just a tremendous, strong psychological ploy by Dino Bravo to try and unnerve Santana, and quite honestly, it's not the least bit successful.
Not going to be able to stand around in the Royal Rumble, Alfred, because 30 of the top stars, the two-minute intervals, every man for himself. You're really going to have to fight your way through.
Oh, absolutely. They can attack you from all sides, front, back, maybe drop on you from overhead, too. It's a very, very dangerous form of combat. And, you know, you keep talking about the luck of the draw. Well, there are some people who don't really need the luck of the draw in that particular match. And I'd say that he would be one of them. He has tremendous stamina.
Dino Bravo taking his time once again as the fans give him another course of boos. Don't forget, there's going to be additional security this year as far as the drawings are concerned. Because of some accusations, implications of last year. There's a knife edge from Bravo. High impact maneuvers up against Tito Santana. Sending him to the ropes. And a dump out of the way. And again, Santana with some momentum. Here it comes. Flying body press. He has a two count. And Bravo powers up. Hip toss. Santana, boy, when he gets wound up, he's with the best. And down and out goes Bravo.
What a series of moves there by Santana. That was really classical wrestling at his best there. And Santana
moves there by Santana.
And Dino Bravo, as we take a look at him, is a tremendous wrestler, one of the best. But when the action gets that pace, it's really all Tito Santana.
It is indeed, because he is a very, very fast, skillful wrestler. And the better thing for Bravo to do there was to bail out under those circumstances. Mind you, he was almost kicked out.
Here's another question, Alfred. Do you think Dino Bravo wants to save something for the Royal Rumble? Do you think he's thinking ahead?
Yes, he may possibly be thinking ahead. You're absolutely right there. I mean, it would be foolish of him to risk an injury at this stage of the game. He's better off bailing out and trying to recover, regroup, come back in again. But at the same time, he doesn't want to lose this match to Santana. It goes down on his record, sets him back a pace or two.
Tito wants him back in. Both men tie up. And once again, Bravo quick to the attack, but Tito counters with the wrist lock. Twisting, twisting, twisting again, and Bravo goes down. The referee checks in, and Santana likes to slow him down, but he likes to be in control when he does.
Yes, he does. Absolutely right. You know, what you said just then has typified this belt right from the opening bell here. Santana is quicker to respond than Bravo is quick to attack. So that has been what has helped Santana so much.
Tito Santana pulling on the arm.
Well, yes, and Santana has dictated the pace, the tempo of this match, and he's done that very, very well indeed. He is a great wrestler. He has tremendous assets.
Bravo just about up. He's up again, but Santana holding out of the hammerlock. Bravo trying to escape. A mess of Dino Bravo. Look at that upper body. And he missed. Tito with a great hip dunk. Bravo back up, but down once again. Tito is in control of this match.
Tito Santana and Dino Bravo knocking themselves out, looking for a victory here. Victory so important in this type of matchup to enhance the career of either individual. True or false? You wouldn't know anything about that. You haven't enhanced anybody's career in a year. This one a long way from being over. We'll be back to the tag team champions.
Don't wrap me up.
Thing of great importance, some earth-shattering. Go ahead, speak. The floor is yours.
Do I have time now? Are you going to allow me time to...
The floor is yours.
It's concerning the Royal Rumble.
Go ahead. Go right ahead.
On the 21st...
Let's go back to ringside.
You know, Alfred, I don't think I agree with that comment. You actually believe what you say, don't you?
Well, I do, because I think at this moment, Bravo has good stamina, and he can make a comeback here, but he's got to concentrate a little more on the, you know, the part where he's got to sink his way into this match.
All right, well, that remains to be seen throughout this match. Dino Bravo has liked to slow the pace down. Tito Santana has liked to pick it up, although it's slowed down right now. Tito is in control, and Dino really has time to plot some strategy here, because...
Santana can display is that he can play with the tempo of the match. He can slow it down, he can pick it off, and that will be very, very upsetting to your rhythm. Believe me, I know about that.
Back to the corner, headbutt that time by Bravo. Nicely done. And a right hand. Again, one more time, the referee getting on Bravo. Tito waiting on him, though, and now the combination blow. A lot more power that time, as Tito with a right cross sends Bravo right down the one knee.
Yes, it looks as if Bravo has lost a lot of that power, because those blows didn't seem to have too much effect against Tito.
Santana tried a monkey flip, but Bravo caught him, and that was a great move by the Canadian Strongman.
Oh, he is a dangerous wrestler, Bravo. That was a great move he put on Santana there. He can really turn something around in a flash.
High elbow came down, and Santana kicks out after that cover by Bravo. It doesn't take long for Bravo to change the complexion of a match, nor to get all the confidence back. And now, with a camel clutch, look at this.
And that's typical of Bravo. When he gets on top, he likes to taunt his man, scoff, and mock at him, and try and make him irate. And he does that very, very successfully. Santana now suddenly finds himself in a considerable amount of trouble.
Pulling up on the chin and the neck.
Look at that look on Bravo's face there, saying, I've got you now, just where I want you. But is he in that position at all? Because although we can see him sitting on Santana, pulling way back on that neck, Santana may be thinking of something else.
Santana trying to just push right out of it. Alfred, how different it's going to be for the Royal Rumble, because a move like this is not going to help you eliminate your opponent.
Oh, no, that's disaster, in fact, because you're a sitting target for somebody else. That's You've right. got to keep on the move all the time.
That's right.
And somebody will pick you off if you do adopt those type of tactics. A nice back slide here.
Well, Bravo, it's going to be very, very difficult to get him over. Bravo is such a strong man.
Did so well to bring Bravo over there. In fact, it was pure skill that did that. Brute strength is not winning out necessarily against the skill and finesse of Santana.
And he brazenly turns his back on Santana. He grabs Santana once again, this time at a bear hug.
Santana now is finding himself increasingly in worse situations as this belt goes on. In fact, the longer it goes, I think the better this stands or augurs for Dino Bravo. Bravo, who's doing so well now. But he is a notoriously slow starter, Tony.
Well, you could see that Tito is in a lot of pain. Bravo clamps it on tighter and tighter. The referee checks in. Now, Santana apparently is going to try to get his arms under Bravo's and slip out of them. I don't think he can power out of this, Alfred. I would think a shot to the head of the eyes would be his only defense, or get to the ropes.
Yes, well, let us see what Santana does do under these circumstances. He is very innovative as a wrestler. He may have something really good for Bravo here.
That's right. Who am I to tell him what to do, right? He knows what he's doing, and let's see what he can do to get out of it. Santana.
He's obviously thinking this one out, and maybe this is a ploy on Santana's part. Give Bravo a lot of confidence that he has him almost beaten.
Well, you said out, thinking it out, but was he almost out? The answer is no, he is okay. Here he goes. He's going to go right to the head. Maybe no, Bravo cuts him off.
And the longer this goes, the more chance, strangely enough, Santana has of escaping. Because that power is gradually ebbing from the body, that powerful upper body of Dino Bravo.
It's gradually doing what?
Ebbing.
Ebbing. I learn a new word every week. And the bear hug from Bravo. On the chest. Go ahead, Alfred.
I was going to say, look at Santana. You can see it almost going through his head there. I will get out of this, and he has done that.
Yeah, he just took a right hand. Way right out of it, but no, right to the eyes again goes Bravo. He picks up Santana. Big slam. Dino Bravo in command again. But once again, turns away from his opponent. And let's see what he has. My goodness, he's going outside. Is he going to try a high risk maneuver here?
Well, he's very careless if he is, because he's turned his back on Santana and left him there for a long time, too.
He is. He's going up, but Santana able to get to his feet. Santana beats him. He's the first one to get a blow in. And you see Bravo slumping down as Santana got up. A very, very procrastinating Dino Bravo enabled Santana to get up.
Yes, he was ill-advised to do that maneuver. That was not Bravo. He's not at home up there. He should never have done that. And now he's paying the price of that.
Heads to the turnbuckle. Santana trying to get some offense going here after all the force of Dino Bravo was wrapped around his back. To the other corner, the fans count right along here in Hamilton, along with...
And the surprising thing to me, Tony, is the fact that Santana's mustered up some energy from somewhere. He's dug down very deep.
He is calling for the flying forearm, and as you see the capacity crowd on hand, here he goes! Bravo picks him up! Oh, a great move, and a cover, and a win for Dino Bravo! Wow!
Here's your...
Sensational, Lord Aberdeen.
It was indeed, what a tremendous move that was by the big French Canadian. Wow, what a
obviously we'll get another crack at each other, and it could all happen in the Orlando Arena in Florida on January 21st at the Royal Rumble.
A lot of good friends of mine are going to be there. Tim Raines from the Montreal Expos.
You didn't promise anybody any tickets, did you?
Mets pitcher Frank Viola. They're all friends of mine. They'll be there. Oh, they're making millions. They can buy their own tickets. You know, that good of friends.
Just remember that. The friends you've got, you can count on one hand, Brain, and have
Andre,
a few fingers
Haku,
left.
Ravishing
those
Rick,
guys you have to pay. Those
DBLC.
Guys aren't friend of yours.
Monsoon, Skolin.
You can scratch me and Skolin from the list right now, I guarantee you. And after the Royal Rumble is over, you can scratch a few of those other guys that you mentioned, too.
No,
Andre's, I heard Andre talking to a couple of guys. He's a little fed up at getting only 15%.
No, you're trying to start trouble. I have nothing to do with Andre's money. He handles his own money. There's one man that does what he wants to do.
He handles whatever you give him.
That's
and your modus operandi is 85% for the Brain and 15% for the guys
never been in modus.
Who get out there and do the work, right?
It's not that way at all. And you've been saying that since Haku's from the islands, that I've been taking advantage of him. Believe me, the man is making more than he's ever thought of making. He's doing wonderful. Great.
It's common knowledge, folks, that he's reaming these guys. We'll be right back after we take a look at where the WWF is headed.
It's the World Wrestling.
I'm Time Wrestling. We'll be right back here next week, same time, same station, here on the USA Network. And talking about networks, let me remind you once again, if for any reason whatsoever your cable company does not intend to carry the World Wrestling Federation pay-per-view events, such as the Royal Rumble or WrestleMania 6 or any other WWF pay-per-view event, make your feelings known. Pick up that phone, call your system, write a letter, sit down, write a letter to your congressman, to your senator. All those things will help ensure that you have the ability to partake of all the World Wrestling Federation pay-per-view events. I know you feel the same way.
Well, you know, it's a shame that the children and the older folks and the people that are shut-ins that can't get around can't get down to Orlando, and they look forward to seeing it on pay-per-view. But then again, if you look at it another way, if few people that are shut-ins and can't get around would have saved your money, you could have bought a car, and if you took care of your kids, they'd be there to help you and take you out of the house.
Are you going to start?
What? Just telling the truth. Bunch of parasites. I don't care if you watch it or not. I'm going to be there.
That particular procedure 2 weeks ago cost you $5,000. You want to consider continuing that same vein?
Notice how we got rid of Piper? Your plan worked.
No. Piper is not here because Piper did something that you did not do. He put his hands on the producer of this program. That is why he is history. Plus, he no longer wished to be on the program that you had anything to do with.
Because he couldn't shine in the light I
spread out. Spread out, huh? You're going to be spread out, Brain, if on January 21st at the Royal Rumble at the Orlando Arena in Florida, you get yourself anywhere near Hot Rod. He'll be there.
Right, some good friends of mine are going to be there. Tim Raines from the Montreal Expos. Frank Viola from the New York Mets.
You don't have any friends. Let's be real.
I didn't promise.
And don't promise anybody any tickets.
They make millions of dollars. I ain't going to pay for those.
Until next week, a little monsoon for the liar saying so long, everybody.
Going back.